Hello, you're watching New Vision TV. This is news around East Africa. My name is Lynn Komjo. We'll start off with Kenya. At least 10 people have died and more than a dozen others injured after a Wajir-bound bus collided with a trailer on the Garissa-Mwingi Road. The accident occurred a few minutes to midnight Sunday and 10 people died on the spot. Two more succumbed to their injuries on the way to hospital. The crash at Tula area between Bangal and Garissa town involved a Nasib Circle bus that had left the capital Nairobi Sunday evening. Reports indicate the bus with 50 passengers on board rammed into a trailer that had stalled on the road. The trailer transporting cement tore into the bus and ripped away windows and a section of the roof, injuring many. In Tanzania, a Tanzanian opposition activist has been found beaten and unconscious at a village in the country's southern highlands 5 days after identified people abducted him, stoking new fears of an opposition crackdown. Mudude Njagali, a young activist with the main opposition Chadema party, was found late Wednesday at a village near his hometown of Mbeya, his party announced. Opposition groups say several campaigners have been attacked over the past 3 years after they criticized President John Magufuli's government, accused by critics of authoritarian rule since he came into power in late 2015. In Uganda, Border 2010, Patron Haji Abdallah Kitatta has been found guilty of unlawful possession of firearms by the General Court Martial. The case was presided over by a 7-member panel led by Lieutenant General Andrew Guti. Kitatta and 9 others were battling charges of unlawful possession of firearms, ammunition, and military gear. In South Sudan's capital Juba will ban all clubs and limit bar hours due to alleged immoral acts taking place in night sports, according to the presidency. Jubek state government has banned all nightclubs, bars and night music shows, a statement issued by the presidency said. The governor, Jubek state, Agustino Jadala Wani, said in a video posted on Facebook that while nightclubs would be shut, bars would have their hours limited to early evening and would be forbidden from operating during the day. Away from East Africa, we'll take a look at what's making headlines elsewhere in Africa. We'll start off with Sudan. Sudan's army rulers and protesters are to hold fresh talks over handing power to a civilian administration Monday, spokesman for the Generals and the Prospect Movement said. On Saturday, the Alliance for Freedom and Change, an umbrella for the protest movement, said the generals had invited it for a new round of talks after several days of deadlock. No explanation has been given on why the talks were postponed, but sources in the alliance said that more time was needed for consultations within the leadership. The talks are being held in an optimistic atmosphere and that the negotiations are aimed at reaching an agreement over the arrangements of the transitional period. In Burkina Faso, gunmen killed 6 people attending mass at the Catholic Church of Dablo in northern Burkina Faso Sunday morning, officials and witnesses said. The priest and 5 churchgoers were among the victims. The attackers were about 40 on motorcycles, made everyone lie down and executed 5 before torching the church, according to a witness. The attackers set parts of the church and nearby shops on fire before fleeing the scene roughly an hour and a half after they arrived. Multiple injuries have been reported. Last week, a gunman killed 5 people in a Protestant church in the small northern town of Siligaji. In the UK, British Prime Minister Theresa May's Conservatives have fallen to 5th place in an opinion poll ahead of the May 23rd European parliamentary election as pressure grows for her to set a date for her own departure. Nigel Farage's Brexit Party was in the lead at 4 percentage points and 34%, while May's Conservative Party had just 10%. The opposition Labour Party was down 5 points on 16%. 2 parties which support staying in the EU, the Liberal Democrats and the Greens, were on 15% and 11% respectively. The collapse in support for the Conservative Party is piling pressure on May to set a date for her departure. Senior Conservatives want May to set out her plans this week. News coming in from Iran. Iran said Monday it had sentenced an Iranian woman to 10 years in prison for spying for Britain. As tension rises between Tehran and some Western countries over its nuclear and missile programs, Ismaili said the woman was in charge of projects for cultural infiltration in Iran. He did not identify her, but said she was a student in Britain before being recruited by the British Council. The woman has been in custody for almost a year, and it's not known if she holds a British nationality. The British Foreign Office did not immediately respond to an email requesting comment. The British Council's Britain's cultural agencies overseas. The arrest of Iranians accused of espionage has increased since Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei said last year there had been infiltration of Western agents in the country. Iran has been increasingly at odds with Western countries since the United States withdrew from a deal Tehran signed with global powers to curb its nuclear program in return for the lifting of sanctions. News coming in from Sweden. Julian Assange is to be investigated in Sweden in a rape case dating from August 2010. The WikiLeaks founder, currently in Balmersh prison in London, now faces likely extradition from Britain. An arrest warrant was issued and Julian Assange was declared an internationally wanted suspect in November 2010 after Assange skipped bail in the UK and went into hiding at the Ecuadorian embassy in London. The extradition order was impossible to enforce. In November 2016, Assange was interviewed by Ecuadorian prosecutors after an agreement was reached between Sweden and Ecuador to cooperate in criminal investigations. Now, news coming in from China. China will never surrender to external pressure, the government said Monday, though stopped short of announcing how Beijing will hit back after Washington renewed its threat to impose tariffs on all Chinese imports in an escalating trade dispute. The trade war between the world's top two economies jumped up a gear Friday, with the United States hiking tariffs on $200 billion worth of Chinese goods after President Donald Trump said Beijing broke the deal by reneging on an earlier commitment made during months of negotiations. Trump also ordered U.S. Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer to begin imposing tariffs on all remaining imports from China, a move that would affect about an additional $300 billion worth of goods. Beijing has vowed to respond to the latest U.S. tariffs, but has announced no details yet. And that was news around East Africa and around the world. My name is Lynn Komdisha. I leave you with Ruth Nasija, taking a look at what's making headlines in today's New Vision.